thought was well done. After each shot, you will get feedback as to how accurate your shot was in the bottom right-hand corner. In the middle of that circle, there's a white stripe, and that is your swing plane, and that is where your swing needs to live. The more difficult the shot, the more narrow your swing plane will be, so pay attention out there. Now let's try another swing and keep it inside that white stripe. Good job on that one. And you're also going to receive feedback on your swing timing, and that's the meter that kind of wraps around the top of your swing accuracy indicator. Your backswing timing refers to the point at which you transition from backswing into downswing. If you do this too early, you're going to reduce the power of your shot. Good job. That's what we're looking for. Congratulations. You've got the basics down, Pat. Can't wait to see it. In this lesson, we're going to talk about one of the most important skills you can have at your disposal, and that is putting. Now, to begin your putt, pull back on the right stick. The farther you pull back, the stronger your putt will be. When you feel you've... That's the stuff. Now, getting your putt strength just right comes down to feel at the end of the day, and each green can feel different. You can keep an eye on your putter's max distance in the top right to get an idea of what the current green speed is. This putt is just a few inches downhill, so use your left stick to move the putting marker just in front of the hole, and then ease up on your putt and let gravity do the work for you. That's what we're looking for. Those moving dots on the grid are telling us that your putt is going to break to the right, so you're going to have to aim to the left to compensate. Use the left stick to adjust your aim before putting so that you can drop this one in the hole. Well, that didn't quite pan out. Let's give that another go. Let's just go ahead and give that another try. Well done on that lesson. And with that, you... Hello and welcome to this lesson where we will talk about clubs and shot types. I am going to show you how to make the most of what's in your golf bag with a few simple tricks. Okay, so for this shot, you're hitting into the wind. This means you are going to have to club up, or in other words, use a longer club. So let's press the change club button until you get to the pitching wedge, then just pop this shot onto the green. Well, not quite. Let's try that again. Not quite there, is it? Let's try again. Well, no need to linger on this lesson. Now, it's only a matter of time before you find yourself in a situation where the normal shot type is just not going to do. Now, to get on the green from here, you are going to need a chip shot. So let's press the change shot type button until you get to the chip shot, and then chip that ball nice and close to the pin with your next stroke. Nice work. Information about the current lie of your ball is available always in the top right corner of the screen. This will give you a range of how much spin and power your shot will retain, and then you can use that info to adjust your shot accordingly. For this particular situation, let's change our club to the sand wedge and then change our shot type to a splash shot, which is a great shot for getting out of these greenside bunkers. After that, give that swing a go. See if you can stick it close. Well, you've got the hang of this one. And now that you know a thing or two about shots... Hello there, and welcome to the lesson on advanced shots. In this lesson, we're going to learn about techniques you're going to want to master if you want to compete with the pros. Let's begin. In this situation, we are going to need to take a partial swing. If you chip this with full power, it's going to blow right by the hole. So we are going to have to move our aim marker closer to us to compensate. Move the aim marker a little bit closer to you. Great work. Looks like you've got the hang of that. Manually adjusting the loft of your shots is going to help you get that ball closer to your target. The catch here is that changing your loft also increases the difficulty of your shot. Hold the shot shaper button and press the left stick up to increase your loft. Land this shot near the cup. Your increased loft is going to give that shot a little backspin. It's going to keep that ball from rolling off the green. Not quite. Let's try that again. Not quite. Let's reset. Try again. And let's just go ahead and try that again, okay? That should probably be tried again. We'll chalk that one up as a success. Applying a fade or a draw to your shot can really open up some stroke-saving shortcuts. And you guessed it, this will also increase the difficulty of your shot. Hold down the shot shaper button and press the left stick to the left, and then land this shot on the left side of the driving range. Well, you've got that one down. Well, this is where we part ways, my young Padawan. All that's left for you is to choose a difficulty level, and then customize your golfer in the My Player menu if you want. Have fun, and I'll see you out there on the links.
2K Sports and the Korn Ferry Tour are proud to bring you this year's Q School Final. Without further ado, let's get into the coverage of this exciting event. Pleased you could join us for this first round action. Luke Elvey here alongside Rich Beam. And Rich, what's it like to compete in this nerve-wracking affair?
Luke, All the players in this field want one thing and one thing only, and that is their Korn Ferry Tour card. It's a massive accomplishment. Let's see how this all shakes out. The top 50 on the leaderboard today will get their card.
Big day coming up. Can't wait to see how it unfolds, Rich. This should be an absolute beauty. And let's see what he can do here today. Where did that come from? That's not his style. Yeah, this lies pretty deep here. Game of the seven. Well, that was overclubbed. Didn't quite strike that as cleanly as they would have hoped.
Yeah, it took a bit too much club on that one.
And here we are with the third shot. This would be a great up and down from this spot. This next putt is for bogey. If it's up, it could be in. And there it is. Sitting at one over for the day.
Starting off with the bogey at first, not tragic. You got a lot of holes to make it up. Let's see how they deal with it going forward.
Let's see what happens here on the second hole. Uh-oh, they've hooked this one. Second shot on the second. Oh, clever play that. Just get it back into the fairway. Getting ready to play their third. This one might need to get down a little.
Nicely done.
Putting for birdie. Was on a good line. 12 feet to the cup coming up. Oh, just missed. This one's for bogey. The putt goes in, and that's back-to-back bogeys.
Yeah, making one bad mistake with another, compounding it, not good.
Moving down the leaderboard after that hole. Teeing off here at the third hole. Going with the five wood. Pretty sure that one's headed left. That was never really a comfortable shot for them, was it?
Airmailed the green with that approach.
Oh, that almost went in. Oh, a lovely opportunity to save par here. That was a gallant attempt. Putting for bogey. In she goes. Let's head to the next. Sitting at three over for the day.
And moving down the leaderboard as well.
You've arrived at a par four. This one might roll into the rough. Coming off a streak of three bogeys. Going with the 5-iron here. have the right stuff there.
Yeah, trying to draw that one in there, but not committing to it, leaving it out.
That one just missed the hole. And they'll walk away with a par on this one. Now four back after that hole. Teeing off here at the fifth.
There is no stopping that hook from slowing down anytime soon.
Sitting at three over. Let's make a move. You're just outside the top 20. Woo, back there, horsey. Well, Rich, that's on the surface, but it's in three-putt territory. It's so far away.
Outside chance of the birdie, but a two-putt here is still good.
Thank you. Shame it didn't drop. You'll happily just go ahead and tap that in. Okay, that hole's behind you now. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. This hole's a tough two-shotter, a long par four. This looks to be a fairway seeker to me.
Luke, that did not end up where you said it was going to. It's in the rough.
To be going with the 5-iron. Well, it's fair to say that that approach didn't hit the mark.
Distance control nearly impossible coming out of this rough.
Oh! Well, that was like a laser straight at it. Putting for par. Yeah, well hold. Let's move on to the next. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Teeing off here at the seventh. That was pummeled. Great drive. Second shot here on the seventh. Sitting at three over par. And this putt to move into the top 10. Okay, steady now. 6 feet remaining to the cup. Had a fair bit of pace on that one. Just 10 feet to the cup here. This is a good chance. Well, at least it wasn't a double. Trailing by 6 shots after that hole. And after a bogey at the last, they're looking for a big drive on this hole. this one might just sneak off the fairway. John's down on the course, and do you have a better look at this lie?
Well, shouldn't have too much trouble getting out of here, fellas. It's ended up in a pretty decent lie, all things considered.
Well, you're a ball striker, there's no doubt about that.
Just a fantastic shot. Guaranteed birdie hitting it that close.
Hey, nice looking line. And with that putt, he's bounced back immediately from his previous drop shot. Well, good move there. Anything north on the leaderboard's always pleasant. Here we are at the final hole on the front nine. Going with the hybrid. This is from miles away. Ah, that's a shame. Comes up shy.
Sometimes when you try and get it up the hill, you just forget to hit it sometimes, and seems so in this case.
Well, that hole's behind us. More to play. Solid play finds that player moving up the leaderboard after that hole. Always love a new beginning. Here we are at the opening hole of the back nine, the 10th. Thank you. Oh, good drive. That one should find the fairway. Second shot here at the 10th. Going with the pitching wedge here. Oh, come on, sit. Good shot there. And this putt is for birdie 3 on the scorecard. Ooh, right by the hole. Par putt coming up here. Wow, was that a rush of blood or something? Feet to the cup. Oh, so close. Oh dear, this next putt now for double bogey. And the putt drops, and we're moving on. Our current leader is enjoying a 2-stroke lead. And they'll have to compose themselves now with this tee shot after a double bogey at the last. That was a little untidy, wasn't it? Playing now from the fairway bunker. Well, this one looks like it's heading to the sand. John, you're down there. How's this ball lying?
Sitting up pretty nicely in the sand. Shouldn't have too much trouble getting out.
It's on the green, but still a fair way away from the flag. Well, Rich, think they can make this one?
Look, I got to say, I'm really not liking their chances here, but you never know. Stranger things have happened.
It's got a chance. Oh, I love a player with big heart. You've showed plenty there.
Yeah, in the bunker, off the tee, great recovery.
Teeing off here on the 12th hole. Looked like they were swinging a snake, not a golf club. Oh dear, that's on the beach. It's heading into the rough, I think. And here we are with the third shot. This putt just 5 feet away from the hole. Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it? Just 3 feet to the cup. Good putt, that. Trailing by 7 after that hole. Teeing off here on the 13th hole. Not quite the shot he was wanting. Now, man on the ground, John McCarthy. What's this lie look like, mate?
Well, definitely not where they planned to be, but they could have had a lot worse of a situation. Sitting up pretty good here in the sand.
This one's for birdie. This one's tracking. Fair effort, that. Good birdie. Currently at four over for the day.
And after that good play, moving up the leaderboard.
It's time to tee off here at the 14th hole. Opting for the 5-wood. That one's headed left. That's a shame. Had a chance to hit the green, but couldn't quite get there.
Missing it short there. They will definitely be upset.
All right, safely out of the bunker, and now a chance to make a putt. And he needs this to save par. Well, there's a wild ride. This putt right on 12 feet to the hole. Oh, what a shame. That would have been a nice one to hole. Good opportunity here, just 6 feet to the hole. Well, hold. Now 7 shots behind after that. Here we have a long par four. It's going to take 2 great shots to get on. well struck. From around 170 yards here. Yeah, good safe shot this one. That should find the surface. Not a bad approach that one. Not quite inside the birdie range, but you never know. Hole a long one. Still counts. What an opportunity to make a birdie. Ouch, that hurts. An opportunity to make their par. This one has eyes for the hole. Oh, wonderful effort. Confirms the par. Sitting out six over for the day. Teeing off here on the 16th hole. That hazard was just staring at you the whole time. So hard not to hit it in there. Getting ready to play their third. This one looks like it'll safely make the green. Let's see if you can make this. Keep the par on the card. Ah, that's frustrating. Bogey putt coming up here. Let's take a look at the leaderboard. Trailing by 8 strokes now after that hole. Teeing off here on the 17th hole. Got to hope that putter turns into a magic wand here, Rich. A couple of birdies. Whew, they need it badly. Looks like they've got the 5-wood. Oh, this would be handy if it could bounce right. Yeah, quality shot that. 16 feet to the cup. just didn't drop. If can make this one, it's for par. This one's looking good. Yep, you'll take that. Managing to maintain their position on the leaderboard. Teeing off here at the lucky last, the 18. That reminded me of the Big Easy. Silky smooth. Second shot here at the 18th. And here we are with the third shot.
Yeah, that'll work. That's fine.
There's part of about 6 feet coming up. And with that, this player has finished their Q School final, but Rich, unfortunately, they didn't manage to make it to that all-important top 50 and won't be able to advance to the Korn Ferry Tour next season. However, on their side is the opportunity to do it all again next year.
The player's going to have a rough go of it for another year until they can get back and hopefully get into the Korn Ferry Tour Championships.
A fair bit of soul-searching, I would imagine.
There's going to be a lot of searching for your game a little bit. I mean, you're going to be traveling, living on the road full-time. It's not easy nor fun, but it can and hopefully will make this player better in the future.
Well, on behalf of myself, Luke Elvey, and Rich Beam, thanks for tuning in. Catch you tomorrow. Sports and the Korn Ferry Tour are proud to bring you this year's Q School Final. It's time to get underway, so let's get into the coverage of this exciting event. Pleased you could join us for this final round action. I'm Luke Elvey, here alongside Rich Beam. And Rich, this next golfer starts their round. What do you think about their chances today?
Look, this player starts off the final round a couple behind the lead. And let's face it, they need to have some inspiring golf out there today. They need to make birdies early and often if they want to chase down that leader. It sets up for a very exciting final round.
I'm looking forward to today, that's for sure. going with the 8-iron here.
Just a bit outside into the rough.
Here's a chance to get up and down from the greenside bunker.
They made bogey on this hole yesterday, and right now they are staring at the same number right square between the eyes.
Okay, so that's step one, but now going to hold a mid-range putt. Ooh. 5 feet coming up to the cup. Ooh, nice line. That's well hold. Starting the round above par today.
Yeah, but if you look how they played the hole, it was disastrous. Lucky to walk away with a bogey.
Well, I like the look of the line here. It should find the fairway. Time for the second shot here on the second hole. Getting ready to play their third. Good look at a birdie here. Oh, just missed. 3 feet to go here to the hole. And down it goes. Let's head to the next. Sitting at 7 over for the event. Par threes always offer up that hope of a hole in one. Going with the 5-wood. It's fair to say that wasn't their best shot.
Wind is absolutely swirling in this part of the golf course.
All right, John, how's this putt looking?
Looks like about 22 feet to the hole.
Was on a good line. And this one will be for bogey. And a little slide happening here on the leaderboard. See if he can bounce back. Let's see what happens here on the fourth. Oh, absolutely flushed. Second shot here on the fourth. Going with the 6-iron here. This one might need to sit. That's not what they were looking for.
That's been the story of the day, isn't it, Luke? It has missed a lot of greens, and you can't afford to do that on this golf course.
Ooh, wouldn't that have been nice? This putt to move into the top 20 on the leaderboard. And down it goes. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. It's time to step on the tee here at the fifth. Looks like this one's contracted the dreaded hooks. That'll flick a few of the leaves going through there. Well, Rich, this looks like a familiar spot for this player.
They had a good result yesterday. Can't see why they wouldn't have another good one today.
Opting for the 5-iron. This one's going right at the pin here. Okay, not the best result, but a chance to get up and down.
Looking for the draw, but not finding it.
Oh, wonderfully played chip shot.
Oh, Dr. Chapinski strikes again.
The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Let's see what happens here on the sixth. Yeah, this is a quality-looking shot, this one. That should find the short stuff. Second shot here on the sixth. Looks to be going with a hybrid here. We need this one to bounce right. Well, at least it's on the green. That's the positive.
There's a long way, but I tell you what, I've seen it happen before, so there's a chance.
Well, that's a mistake. Tough to leave that short. Well, this would be a good one to make. It's for par. Whoa, back there, horsey. This putt is about 10 feet from the hole. Oh, so close. And this putt to move into the top 20. Yeah, well hold. Let's move on. And a little slide down the standings after that hole. You've arrived at a par 5. Shank that one. Well, this should affect the ball flight. Ooh, sometimes you need a hacksaw to get out of this rough.
No, this is like hitting it into a head of cabbage. I mean, it literally is just awful.
Might get caught up in the brush here. That's straight into the trees. No, that's not the shot they wanted. And here we are with the third shot.
Wind is blowing from right to left here. Wants to work it against the wind.
That's not what they hoped for. I'm definite about that. Oh, my. That's a putrid lie. Can he get out of here?
No, I'm not seeing a whole lot of ball in the sand here, guys. Let's see how they deal with this one.
He has this putt to save his par. Oh, so close. Pretty straightforward four-footer coming up here. That's a good putt to hole for a bogey. Sitting at 11 over for the event. Let's see what happens here at the 8th. I'd be booking in for some lessons if I was swinging it like that. Second shot here on the eighth.
No harm, no foul there with that shot.
Well, Rich, from where I'm sitting, this looks makeable. Do you agree?
Luke, I got to say, I don't like their chances. I have been wrong once before, but I really can't remember when that was.
Big chance here. Oh, that's a lengthy putt. Well hold. Well, that was a positive hole. A little shift up the leaderboard. Well played. Teeing off here at the ninth hole. Opting for the hybrid, I think. Oh, that was left all the way off the club. This would be a great up and down. Go ahead and make it. What a shot! Almost went in the bucket. Big par saver coming up for this fella. Ooh, right by the hole. This one is for bogey. It's half a chance of being holed, this one. Well, that's disappointing. This putt's for double. Okay, let's head to the next. And as we head over to the 10th hole, Rich, this player will enter their final nine holes of Q School. How will they be feeling?
Luke, this is the spot where you either fail or shine. And I gotta say, nine holes left to put themselves in the top 50 to make it on the Korn Ferry Tour. Failing is definitely an option for this player.
Well, a man on the ground, John McCarthy, would have a better look at this. How's it lying?
Well, they lucked out here. I mean, they did get into some deep rough, but the lie ended up being not too bad.
That approach didn't seem to fit their eye.
Not easy to find the green coming out of the rough.
Tate, steady now. And that should secure the par. Well done. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. Teeing off here at the 11th. That's heading for the fairway. Not sure if this one will stay on the short grass. Getting ready to play their third. And this putt is for a big four on the scorecard. That was a little bit too much power. Pretty good chance here. This one's for par. Get excited. This could go in. And down she goes. And staying right where they were in today's rankings after that. Let's see what happens here at the 12th. John, what's this one looking like?
Yeah, they're in the sand, and it's sitting up pretty good in this sand. Pretty good lie.
Got some good distance on that one. And here we are with the third shot. Well, I hope he makes this one. It's for par. Job done. Let's head to the next. Sitting at 12 over for the event. Let's see what happens here at the 13th. Good-looking shot, this. Second shot here on the 13th. That might be one club too many. Attaboy, good shot. This putt coming up is for birdie. That was a gallant attempt. And with that, you can go and put a par on the card. And after that effort, let's take a look at how it stands. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. Let's see what happens here at the 14th. That'll work. Up on the dance floor. Could have been worse.
Slim chance for a birdie, but in all reality, two putt for par would be just fine.
Yeah, a bit long on that one. 7 feet to the cup. Ah, that's frustrating. 4 feet to the cup. Good-looking putt, and that's for a bogey. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. Teeing off here at the 15th hole.
There's nothing going to slow that golf ball down after that wicked hook.
And from the bunker here.
Yeah, they parred this hole yesterday, but from easier circumstances today, a little more difficult, but still doable.
Well, that was a good strike. Getting ready to play their third. That one's come up short. Big putt for par coming up. Ouch, that hurts. This is a bogey putt coming up. Well, that's going to sting. Back-to-back bogeys at the wrong time.
Two bogeys in a row, never a good sign. Now playing a little defensively.
Let's see what happens here at the 16th. This one should find the rough. Well, Rich, in the thick stuff here, not a good spot to be.
I'm telling you, I would blame the caddy. Bogey here yesterday, looking at the same score today.
Game with the 9-iron, I think. Yeah, that one will play. 16 feet to the hole. Well, that's criminal. How do you leave that short?
I hate to use the word choke, Luke, but that's exactly what happened there. A flat-out choke.
Let's see what happens here at the 17th. Opting for the 5-wood. And he's safely on the green with that shot.
Outside chance here for the birdie.
little bit of a rush of blood by the looks of it. Looks like a pretty straightforward five-footer to me. And in it goes for the par. Sitting at 14 over for the event. All right, one more hole to go. Let's see how you handle the 18th. That looks to be a fairway finder to me. Time for the second shot on the 18th. And here we are with the third shot. That's on the green, but still a fair way from the hole. This putt for a final score of 79. And with that, this player has finished their Q School final, but Rich, unfortunately, they didn't manage to make it to that all-important top 50. And won't be able to advance to the Korn Ferry Tour next season. However, on their side is the opportunity to do it all again next year.
The player's going to have a rough go of it for another year until they can get back and hopefully get into the Korn Ferry Tour Championships.
A fair bit of soul searching, I would imagine.
There's going to be a lot of searching for your game a little bit. I mean, you're going to be traveling, living on the road full time. It's not easy nor fun, but it can and hopefully will make this player better in the future.
Well, on behalf of myself, Rich Beam, and all the hardworking folks at HB Studios, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.